Endurance Sweat here with my comprehensive guide to estimating Swift route ride times for flat routes and for climbing routes. Estimating your ride time for a flat route, well, that's pretty simple. Take the route distance and divide it by your expected average riding speed. So for example, the route Douce-France, it's 24 kilometers long with only 133 meters of climbing, so virtually no climbing. So if you expect to ride at an average speed of, say, 30 kilometers an hour, divide 24 by 30, and that will give you a result of 48 minutes. But what about a climbing route? Well, that's not so simple. You take your route distance and divide it by your expected average riding speed, but then you have to add an extra allowance for all that climbing. Take, for example, Octobahn, 47.4 kilometers long with 989 meters of climbing. That's a lot of climbing. So what would your ride time be? Well, take 47.4 kilometers and divide it by your expected average riding speed, say 30 kilometers an hour. And that would give you 1 hour and 35 minutes. But what about all that climbing? Well, that's what this video was all about. So ascent versus distance. Meters climbed equal how many kilometers of flat riding. That is, for the same effort, how far would you go on a climb versus on a flat route? I used two methods to estimate the answer to that question. First, I used an energy consumption while cycling formula that I found on the web. And secondly, I did a Swift test ride using a wheel-on dumb trainer. Here's an energy consumption while cycling calculator that I found on the web. You can see the web address at the top. On the box on the right-hand side, I input into the calculator a ride at a speed of 10 kilometers per hour for 60 minutes, so a 10 kilometer ride. For a 75 kilogram rider and with a slope or grade of 10%, so 1,000 meters of climbing. And it came out to an energy consumption of 4,171 kilojoules. Now on the box on the right, I left the duration of 60 minutes the same, thing, 75 kilogram rider, but I put the slope or gradient at zero, so no climbing. And then I input different speeds to come up with the same energy consumption, and that worked out to 30.39 kilometers. So the delta ascent is 1,000 meters, and the delta, or difference in distance ridden, is 20.39 kilometers. So dividing the ascent by the distance, or 1,000 divided by 20.4, came out to 49.2 meters per kilometer. So that means for every 49.2 meters of climbing you do, is equivalent to 1 kilometer of flat riding. Now let's look at my second means of estimating the answer to that question. I did a test ride to the Epic KOM banner on the Big Loop route using my Kirkkinetic Road Machine, Dumb Trainer. And I recorded the route on Zwift, so as a climbing route, but I also recorded the route using my Garmin head unit. And that's equivalent to a flat route because the resistance on my Dumb Trainer doesn't go up even when the road goes uphill on Zwift. So here are the results of my test. Recording the route on Zwift as a climbing route, the distance was 14.5 kilometers to the King of the Mountain banner on the Epic KOM climb, and the ascent was 435 meters. And recording it on my Garmin head unit, the distance was 23.9 kilometers, but zero ascent. So taking the difference in ascent of 435 meters and dividing it by the difference in the distance, or 9.4 kilometers, or 435 divided by 9.4, gives a result of 46.2 meters per kilometer. So every 46.2 meters of climbing is equivalent to 1 kilometer of flat riding. Now that result is surprisingly close to the estimate that we got using the formula of 49.2 meters per kilometer. So rounding the results, my rule of thumb is 50 meters of climbing is roughly equivalent to 1 kilometer of flat riding. Or converting to imperial units, 100 feet of climbing is roughly equivalent to 1 mile of flat riding. Let's see how my rule of thumb would apply to some of the tougher climbing routes on Zwift. Octobahn, 47.4 kilometers long, with 989 meters of climbing would be roughly equivalent to 67.2 kilometers of flat riding. The Four Horsemen, 89.2 8 kilometers long, 2,108 meters climbing. That'd give you 132 kilometers of flat riding. The Megapretzel, 107.3 kilometers long, 1,638 meters of climbing, would be equivalent to 140.1 kilometers of flat riding. The Uberpretzel, 128.3 kilometers in length, with over 2,000 meters of climbing, 2,379 meters, would be equivalent to 175 kilometers of flat riding. And the full PRL, 173.4 kilometers long, that's already mighty long, with a whopping 2,023 meters of climbing, would work out to 225.9 kilometers of flat riding. A lot of riding. So for each of those routes, the time to ride estimates at an average speed of 30 kilometers an hour for Achterbahn would be 2 hours and 14 minutes, for the Four Horsemen, 4 hours 24 minutes, Megapretzel, 4 hours and 40 minutes, the Uberpretzel, 5 hours and 52 minutes, and the full PRL, 7 hours and 32 minutes. And don't forget, you need to add some extra time for breaks, so take that into account as well. So for your riding time estimate, add ascent equivalent kilometers. And my rule of thumb is 50 meters climbing is roughly equivalent to 1 kilometer of flat riding, or 100 feet climbing equivalent to 1 mile of flat riding. I hope you found this video to be helpful, and if you have, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, Endurance Sweat. And while you're at it, click on the notification bell. Okay, so long for now. Train hard and have fun.